Welcome to Hands That Rock, No Share With Me, Kenny. Stand out from the rest by making this poncho with your tassel and a lovely cowlick. Gather your materials and let's go on a crochet journey. You can use any yarn with the corresponding crochet hook for this project. I'll be using Aran yarn, which is an 100% acrylic yarn. I'll use two together to make it chunky. 8.0mm crochet hook, scissors. All. Make your chain as long as you want it to be and you're comfortable for it around your neck. I've got 45 chain stitches. Now slip stitch and join into each. Make single crochets all the way around. The reason why I'm working through the back hump is because it gives you a neater edging for your cowl neck. So carry on all the way around. When you walk into the back hump, this is the lovely effect you're going to have. So carry on all the way around. Okay, slip stitch. And then when you got in towards your starting point, you need to be extremely careful that your project is not twisted like so. Your yarn tail needs to be pointing downwards. Okay. This is 44 and that's 45. Now slip stitch into the top there like so. Chain 1, 2. Yarn over. The chain 1, 2 does not count. This chain 2 does not count as anything. It's just a step up. Now go into the same space and make double crochet. Carry on all the way around making your double crochets. You should have a total of 45 crochets if you're following this count. See you, and then slip stitch into the top over there. Slip stitch into the top of the chain 2 space. That's what we've done so far. Chain 2, that doesn't count as any stitch. 1, 2, yarn over, front post round your first double crochet and back post the next. Front post again and back post. And carry on like this all the way around. When you get to your chain 2 space, slip stitch chain 2 and then front post, back post, front post, back post all the way. And this is how you're going to grow the cowl part of your poncho. If you want to, with your yarn tail, this is your joining part, just weave it in. all the way. Weave it in as best as you want to, and that's, this will be the top part and the bottom. With my cowl neck, I made a total of 16 rows, so it's enough for me. If I want to fold it like that, makes it more chunky, I can do like that. Okay, so you can stop wherever you're happy to stop, or you can even leave out and not do the cowl neck, but that's part of the beauty of this design. Once you're happy with your cowl length, okay, this is just to show you how it's gonna be, slip stitch to the top, and then make sure you have on either side same amount, and then in the middle put a stitch marker there. Okay. If you want, if you're used to using a stitch marker, you can put a stitch marker there, or just know that once you do equal amounts on one side and on the other side, you have one in the middle, that will be your midpoint. You're gonna have two midpoint. Your starting point will be your first midpoint. Slip stitch into the top of your first double crochet and chain 1, 2, 3. This will count as your first double crochet. Yarn over into the same space, make 2 double crochets. You have a total of 3 double crochets in there, and then chain 2, 1, 2 into the same space, make 3 more double crochets, and this will be your first point. You need 2. This will be your first point. You need 2. There you go. That's the point. And then chain 1. Yarn over. Skip into the next. 3 double crochets into that same space. Chain 1. Skip, and this is our midpoint. So you can take off your yarn marker. And here we're going to make 3 double crochets chain 2 and 3 double crochets all into the same space. Chain 1 after also. And then carry on all the way around, repeating what we've done on this side. Okay. When you get here, you're going to slip stitch on top of your double crochet. So this is what we have done so far. Yarn over, skip the next space, and into the next one after the 3 double crochets. Chain 1, skip 1. We're carrying on. escape from there. From time to time, it's quite normal for your hook to slide off the yarns because we're using double yarn. Yeah, so. But you would like the poncho when you finish. I'm loving mine so far. Yarn over, skip one space there, which is here, because you have the back post. Just skip there into the next, make 3 double crochets, chain 1, and you skip one space, 3 double crochets, chain 1 all the way around, skip in there, yarn over, skip the next, and into the next one after that, make 3 double crochets, chain 1, skip the top of the next double crochet, and into the next one after that, make 3 double crochets, chain 1, and carry on all the way around. And when you get to the midpoint, we'll make another point. When you get here, we'll make another point there. This is what we've done so far. Skip in there, 3 double crochets, chain 1, skip in there, 3 double crochets, chain 1, skip one space after, skip in there, chain 1, skip in there, 3 double crochets, we come into the midpoint. Chain 1, yarn over, skip the next one, and into the next one after that, we make 3 double crochets, chain 1 after, skip into the next, 3 double crochets. When you're making any crochet projects, there might be times when you've done your calculations or you're following somebody's pattern or things like that. If for whatever reason it seems not to be working out for you, you can always adapt the pattern to fit your own need. Because as I've always said, and we've always mentioned here on Answer Raw Crochet, you are the designer, especially if you're making it for yourself. Make it to suit whatever size, shape, or color, or anything that you like. At the end of the day, you have to please yourself, because it's for you. So the most important thing is for you to enjoy your work or whatever you're making, and to enjoy the beauty of crocheting. So now you go into the top of the row, 3 chain stitch, which counts as our first double crochet, slip stitch, and we've completed that round. Remember, this part is the cow part if you make yours longer. Okay, slip stitch into the next, and into the top of the next slip stitch. Now you're in the middle slip stitch. In there, you make 3 chain stitches that will count as your first double crochet. Go into the same point and make 2 more double crochets, because we're trying to make our point. You have two points there to grow your work. You have 2 points there. So we have 1, 2, 3 double crochets. We chain 1, 2 into the same space. We make 3 double crochets, and from now on it is so easy. What you need to do is just to grow and grow your work. If you carry on all the way around like I've shown you, you will come out with your poncho as wide as you want it to be, and then you stop, and then you carry on to the next step, which is to attach your tassel. Okay, see you soon. Happy crocheting. Thank you so much for tuning in, and have a great crochet journey. We hope to see you soon once more on Answer Raw Crochet. If you've got any questions, any request, leave a comment. Thumbs up if you like what you've seen, and have a great day. Bye-bye.